Hi everyone, and welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Priya Mistry and I'm the TMJ doc. This video is about hypermobility in the jaw joints and how this relates to or affects TMJ disorders. If you're aware that you're hyperflexible, if you've been diagnosed with Ehlers-Danlos syndrome, EDS, Marfan syndrome, or joint hypermobility syndrome, or if you're just curious about hypermobility and how it relates to the jaw joints, then this video is for you. For those of you who don't know who I am, I'm a general dentist in Portland, Oregon, with a practice dedicated to taking care of patients with TMJ disorders. If you haven't already, please make sure to check out my Instagram handle. I post here quite frequently lots of tips and tidbits about TMJ stuff. So if you like to geek out on this knowledge like I do, then please be sure to check this out. So let's get right into it. Hypermobility disorders directly affect connective tissue proteins that are in charge of rigidity or toughness. When these proteins are negatively affected, this then makes for looser than ideal connective tissues, which in turn leads to overly relaxed joints, which can partially or fully dislocate or become injured much more easily than in people who don't have hypermobility disorders. The temporomandibular joints, the TMJs, have a ton of connective tissue. Therefore, people with hypermobility disorders have a much harder time with the jaw locking open or closed to where people can barely open more than one or two finger widths. Jaw locking, especially jaw locking closed, is typically associated with muscle fatigue and pain, headaches, jaw pain, neck pain, ear pain, limited range of motion, and these are the symptoms that drive the patients into my office. Please watch my videos Jaw Locked Open and Jaw Locked Closed Parts 1 and 2 for more information on these exact conditions and how we treat them successfully at my office. Lastly, young females tend to be more hyperflexible than males, and this is because of a hormone called relaxin. The vast majority of my patients are young females. Like, we don't go through enough, ladies. So please watch my video Hormones and TMJD for more information on that and how the hormones affect the temporomandibular joints. So that's really it, my friends. If you learned something new, if you like what you heard, click like below, subscribe to my channel, do all the things, and make sure to comment in the comment box below if you have comments, questions, etc. I always make sure I answer everything. And remember, my friends, you can never have TMI about TMJ. Thank you.